JOSM, short for Java OpenStreetMap Editor, is an advanced desktop editor for adding and changing map data on OpenStreetMap. It's free and open source, and one of the things it's great for is drawing buildings quickly. To download JOSM, go to josm.openstreetmap.de. There are a few options for downloading. Choose one of the green ones. JOSM.jnlp is a good option. Note that JOSM works best with a mouse rather than a trackpad. You may need to install a new version of the Java library once you download JOSM as well. Open up JOSM.jnlp. You'll see a gray screen with some news and updates, and a number of buttons. Next, we'll need to add the Buildings plugin. To do that, click the button that looks like two sliders. That's the preferences for JOSM. The fourth button down looks like a little plug. That's the plugin menu. Click on that. Now search for Buildings. You'll see one called Buildings Tool. Click its checkbox, and then click OK. It'll download the plugin, and you'll need to restart JOSM. There are a few other settings we need to change also. Go to the JOSM menu, then Preferences or Settings. The second button looks like a globe. That's the connection settings. Make sure you're logged in with your OpenStreetMap username and password. Then at the second from the bottom button, which is Settings for the Remote Control feature, make sure Remote Control is checked. This will let the humanitarian OpenStreetMap team Tasking Manager use JOSM to download your task. Click OK, and we're ready to map. There are a few ways to start editing in JOSM. Either zoom to an area, or have the humanitarian OpenStreetMap team's Tasking Manager open to an area. The second is probably more likely for what we'll be working on, so let's do that. Go to tasks.hotosm.org and select a task. There's more on the Tasking Manager in other tutorial videos. Click your square, then click Start Mapping. And then, instead of Edit with ID Editor, click the drop-down and select Edit with JOSM. Then click the button. Back in JOSM, it will show you outlines of the data, maybe some roads, buildings, other features. Next, you need to add the imagery. Click the imagery menu at the top of the screen, then select Bing, which is the default. This is also the default for the ID editor. Note that some other tasks might suggest different imagery, like Mapbox Aerial or another source. Make sure to read the instructions for each task. You'll notice some parts of the imagery are clear, and some are covered by crosshatched lines. The clear area is the border of your square from the Tasking Manager. Don't edit outside it. Then we can start drawing buildings with the Buildings tool. The tool will draw perfect rectangles with only a few clicks. Let's zoom in to find a building. To zoom, use your mouse wheel. And to pan, right-click with the mouse button and drag. There's one. Now click the Building button, or B on your keyboard, and trace it. Just three clicks and we have a building. If a building has right angles but is not a rectangle, we can still draw it using the Buildings tool by joining multiple rectangles together. Draw one part first, then draw the other part. Make sure they overlap a little bit. Then click on the selector tool that looks like a finger,
or the S button on your keyboard.
Click one of the rectangles, click Shift on your keyboard, then click the other rectangle, and then click Shift J for join.
Make sure you're highlighting the building itself and not a corner when you select it.
The other great thing about the Building tool is that it will allow you to quickly draw many parallel buildings. For example, here are a number of buildings that are all lined the same way. Let's draw the first one. After drawing it, select it, and keep it selected. Then click the Building tool and draw the next one. It will automatically be parallel to the first building. This way you can draw many parallel buildings quickly. Make sure to deselect that building when you're done, though. You probably also want to zoom in a little bit just to make sure you've got each part of the building. In this case, these last two buildings have a little extra part. We want to make sure we add that. Like before, drawing extra overlapping rectangles, and selecting each part and clicking Shift-J. When you're done, we'll need to save the edits. In JOSM, we're actually editing them only on our desktops, so we need to upload them back to OpenStreetMap. Click on the Upload button, and it will automatically add a comment if you're using the Tasking Manager. This is the same comment as you'd add using the browser-based ID editor. If everything is okay, you'll get a success message. If there are any errors with what you've drawn, it'll tell you. Here's one error message. Let's hit Cancel and see what's wrong. It'll highlight the error on the map, and it will also appear on the Validation Results section on the right side of the screen. In this case, I forgot to join those two parts of the buildings together. Let's select them, click Shift-J, and let's upload again. But first, let's fix the edge of that building.
Something else you can do with JOSM is to simplify shapes by combining vertices or corners. In this case, We joined two rectangles together, but they weren't perfectly aligned, so there's a little corner. Let's zoom in and fix that. Click on one of the vertices that should be joined together, and then click the M button on your keyboard for merge. It'll combine those two points together, and now we have a straight line. Click the Q on your keyboard to square the building, and let's upload it. No error messages this time, so we fixed it. Another neat trick is the ability to copy and paste buildings, like if there's many buildings that are the same size. This is often pretty common in urban areas. So first I'll draw one building. Then I'll select it, hit copy on my keyboard, either Control or Command C, then move the mouse and put it where the next building is, and paste it there with Control or Command V. Do that again to the next place, and you're adding multiple buildings really, really quickly. It's important to make sure you only do this where the buildings are the same size and the same shape, and also facing the same way. If a building is a complicated shape, you can draw it using either the Building tool or the Line tool. Let's use the Line tool on this one. So click on the Line tool, and just like an ID, start clicking on the corners in order to draw the outline. Then, just like an ID, we'll need to tag this building. The Building tool automatically tags the buildings, but if we're using the line, we'll need to tag it ourselves. Click Add under the Tag Memberships window. Start typing building for the key, and it will autocomplete. Then in the next field for value, type yes. Hit OK and the building will turn red. And just like an ID, if this building is a rectangle or has right angles, click on the Q button and it will square those corners. If the area you're working on has circular buildings, you can also draw those. Click the line tool and trace the building. Then when you're done, tag it building yes, like before. Note that JOSM will remember the last tags you used and suggest those. So in this case, it was already tagged building equals yes. We just had to hit OK. And click the O on your keyboard to make it a perfect circle. Since these two round buildings are the same size, we'll copy and paste the next one. Make sure to always upload your changes and be careful with your drawing. JOSM is very powerful, but it's also easy to make mistakes and change other data that's right.